In this tutorial, we're gonna change the WooCommerce default product variations to fancy buttons for a better user experience.
Hi guys, this is Bully. Today, I am going to show you guys how to add a product variation icon feature to your WooCommerce WordPress website for a better user experience. All right, with that being said, let's get started.
All right, let's go to our demo store. We are going to install a plugin. Click plugins. And click the add new button on the top and type product variation in the search box onto your right. That's the plugin we are going to install. It's by Villa Theme. It's called product variation swatches for WooCommerce. Click the install button. Then click the activate button once done. All right, its menu should appear on the left panel right there. And then let's click the first one, which is variation swatches. Here's the dashboard of the plugin. We are going to explore the option number one, which is regular button style. And the first default design is called rectangle buttons. They already set up all the pixels and all the stuff for us already for us to modify or customize it. Right under general settings tab is right here. The button should be selected, and then let's click on the swatches profile, and the first section here is the button design. Click the default styling tab to expand the options. Leave all other values in those fields alone. As of right now, the text is black and the background is white and the border color is black. This is the free version of the plugin, so they already set up a lot of design values for you. The default buttons are white rectangles with black text and border. Let's click the hover styling tab right here. When we hover over a button, we're gonna change this color to another color when somebody hovers over a button using the desktop browsing your website. The hover over button and text will change to another color. Just click into the box and select the color whatever you like according to your branding. And I am going to pick the color from my demo store. I am going to compare this blue color in the Appy Pie design. And I got this bright pink color as the opposite color for my demo store. So I am going to use this color for my buttons. Right click and select copy the hex code and go back to the plugin dashboard and just paste the hex code right here. And change the border color too. And click out. And don't forget to leave the border width as 1 pixel. Then leave the rest of the settings the same, including the border radius, box shadow, color, and change the size of attribute items. Next, let's click the selected styling tab right here to expand its options. And we also want to change its background here too, to the same color and the border color. Once everything looks good, we just scroll down a little bit more to select the tooltip styling section right here. Make sure to check this box to enable it for a better user experience. We want this. As of right now, I think the default color that the plugin team sets up for us, they're pretty good already. There are many options for the position of the tooltip that you could try, like left, right, bottom, but in this case I'm gonna select the top. Once everything looks good, just scroll down to click the save button at the bottom. All right, let's go to the next tab. All right, let's explore the next tab real quick, which is swatches on single page. Just leave all the settings here alone and click the save button. And the next tab is swatches on the product list. Unfortunately, this is the free version, so we can't do anything. Next, it's custom attributes. It's for the premium version to change each attribute to different colors. And let's go to the front end to refresh the page to see the changes. Alright, here it is. All the colors buttons have the same pink color. It's because this is the free version. If you want to change each attribute button to a different color to match each shirt color, you have to go back to the custom attributes tab to buy the premium version of the plugin. It's about $22 on Code Canyon of Invader Market. I may cover this tutorial in the future. Alright, back to the fancy buttons. When you hover over each, you could see a tooltip located on the top of the button. You could see the button and the text color change to the same color too. Alright, let's explore the menu of the plugin real quick. Alright, let's take a look at the left panel, the second menu. It is for global attributes, but this section is for the paid version, or the Woo filter widget. That is for the paid version also. And the next one is extensions. That's all the extensions that they create. And the last link is for if you want to buy the premium version, just click that link. Alright, let's go to the next design, which is for circle buttons. Let's click the variation swatches link on the left panel to go back. And it's still under the button selection right here in the general settings. We're not gonna pick the radio button yet. All right, let's click the swatches profile and select the color design section right here. And let's click the default styling tab to expand to see all the options. Let's change the text color to white, maybe. It's up to you. And let's change the background color also. Be careful about the slider here. If you slide it up, it will make the color solid. And for the border color too, I like my colors to be solid, not transparent. So, and click the hover styling here and change the text color to white. And the background color to whatever colors you like, or it will go with your branding. And I will change up the border radius to 50 pixels to make the button circle. Alright, next, click the selected styling. And right here, just click the text color to black or whatever color that matches your branding. And then I'm gonna change the background and the border color to the same color that I like, or to match with my demo store branding, and change the border radius to 50 pixels and click the tooltip styling right here to enable it for a better user experience and keep all the settings the same for the tooltip. Click the save button at the bottom. All right, let's go to the front end to refresh the page. Click over here to refresh the page. And there you go. All the buttons look round like a circle. That looks good. All right, let's explore the next option. This design is to make your button square. So let's go back to the dashboard. Right here is still the button. And let's go to the swatches profiles and scroll down to the bottom to select this section. Click the image design option right here. Click the default styling tab to expand. Let's focus on changing the background color right here. I just want to change this to black, but it's up to you whatever colors you want to change. That will go with your branding. We just keep the rest of the settings here the same, because they're quite gonna look like a square pretty much. And just leave the border radius alone. And let's click the hover styling. And we are going to change the background color to the bright pink again. And just leave the rest of the settings alone. And let's expand the selected styling. And change the background color to the bright pink and the border color to the bright pink again. And let's expand the tooltip styling and click that button to enable it for a better user experience. And just leave the rest of the settings the same because they already look good. Once everything looks good, just scroll down a little bit to the bottom to click the save button. It shouldn't take that long over here. All right, let's go to the front end to refresh the page to see all the changes. Let's click the refresh button. There you go. All buttons look like a tiny square. It looks like the default button text doesn't look visible. So we need to go back to the plugin dashboard to fix this. Click the default styling tab to find the text color and pull up the slide up and down here. We want this slider to be up on the top to make the color all solid. And we're gonna change the color to white. Well, you could change whatever the color you want it to be. Make sure your text color is visible and very easy to see and read. Let's click the hover styling tab to do the same. Right here, I want to do the same as the default button, so I need to put that slider up to the top to make the text color more solid. Yep, just like that. And then let's go to the next one, which is selected styling. I want to do the same too. And I want the text color to be black. And I need to fix all those sliders like that. And then click the save button. Let's go back to the front end again. Let's refresh this page. All right. They look so much better now because I can read all the text. All right, next is the option number 2 for the radio button style. Let's go back to the dashboard again. Under the general settings right here from the drop-down, select the radio and click the save button. Let's go back to Swatch's profile and then let's select the button design again and click the save button. And let's go back to the front end and refresh this page. Let's see, here it is. So basically a radio button is inside each rectangle button. It's kind of look different. Let's go see, switch to the second design, which is the color design, and let's refresh the page. This one is a circle button. So that's the radio button inside a circle button. What about the third style, which is the image design, and click the save button right here. Let's go back to the front end to refresh it. Let's see how it's gonna look like. Wow, they're kinda tiny squares for this third option with a radio button inside it. All in all, whatever your design would be, you can only choose one option for this free plugin.